What's good, everybody? Hope you guys can see and hear me. I'm right here in downtown LA, so I'm gonna be wearing this mask, right? But this real quick, this is gonna be a quick little story. So let me get away from all the craziness. So when I was a kid, we had came here and I had did school. If you could see, this used to be a parking lot. So we had parked in this parking lot here, and across the street they were filming this movie, and someone says, "Hey, look, it's Tupac," right? So, you know, we waved to him and he was right there, like right across the street. It was this movie called Gridlock. It was about 6 months after he had got out of jail. So somewhere like April of 96, you know, he ended up getting killed September of 96. So this was in April of 96. This movie's supposed to be taking place in Detroit, but they were filming it here. So as you can see, this is where they turned the corner and we waved at him. He waved back right here. We're like, "Hey, Tupac." And, you know, he waved back. So I'm gonna show you right here this path, and then I'll show you the pictures where they're talking to the cops, and you could see you know, everything's changed, everything looks different, but they did keep this historic hotel. So I'm gonna show you guys right now. All right, stay tuned. Hey, what's good? Check it out. So I came across the street now. If you could see over there is where I was at right now, at the parking. So this is where he was walking right here. You know, he came through here. He had this black leather jacket, as you could see. And they turned the corner right here. If you could see way back there, that Hotel Barclay. I'll screenshot the picture of the movie and show you guys, right? So check it out. I just wanted to show you guys where Tim Roth is leaning on this thing. If you see the number, 3008. And then see the Barclay Hotel over there. So I just wanted to show you guys real quick so you could see. So it's still the same meters and the same hotel thing, but everything else looks all crazy, like hipster, and you know, everything changed. Even the walls, right here. You could see them in the movie, it's all crazy. So just wanted to show you guys that real quick. All right. So we kept passing through here. Well, we only passed twice, right? But his bodyguard, Frank Alexander, I guess, you know, we didn't know how serious the situation was, but he got mad, you know, and he said, he was like, "Hey, why y'all keep passing through here?" And, you know, we didn't know how serious the situation was. We were kids. We were all happy that, you know, we saw Tupac walking here. And so, see, I think they ran down this alley too, but everything's changed, right? So, but what up? But see, if you look here, I'll put the screenshot of the Hotel Barclay. So you'll see in the movie, they're supposed to be in Detroit, but it was shot here in downtown LA. And so what happened was, we were passing, you know, we were kids, and my brother had this system, right? So I had ditched school. We came because everything you wanted to get, you could get in downtown LA, right? Like, I used to have these shoes back then. Adidas had came back in style. So I had these shell toe Adidas that were blue with the white shell toe, and you could only find them here in downtown LA. So we'd always come to downtown LA to get stuff, right? All right, so let me tell you the story. You know, I'll edit it however, so it makes sense, right? But so what I was saying was, where we were across right there, across the street, you know, we were kids, we came for something. And you know, it's funny because right as I finished shooting that, some guy on a bike passes with like a little boombox bumping some Tupac. So I was like, all right, that's a funny, you know, coincidence that I was shooting the whole Tupac thing, and this guy passes by, you know, on a bike bumping some Tupac. So anyways, so we were across at that garage place, right? It used to be like a parking, right? I mean, the little square, right? It was a parking thing, right? So then, you know, I was ditching school. We came for some reason. Then as we're leaving, right there, you know, we're going to go into the parking lot. And then we look across and Tupac's there in his long leather jacket or whatever. So someone says, oh, look, it's Tupac. We go, hey, Tupac. And he waves at us. And so then after that, you know, we get in the car, and then I had a cassette tape with, you know, one side, it was a greatest hits thing that I had. On one side, I had the I Get Around song, and then on the other side, I had this song. I think it was called Strictly for the Hustlers or something like that, with Too Short, Tupac, all that. But it was on the Cocktails Too Short album, right? So I had that on the other side, right? So I tell my brother, oh, fast forward, it's at the end or whatever. But the first time we pass by, we're bumping I Get Around. Tupac looks at us. He's waving at us. You know, I was riding, like, in the back on that side where, you know, so I got all happy because Tupac was right there. You know, he's waving at us, bobbing his head. You know, once he hears I Get Around. My brother had two 15-inch speakers and two 10-inches in the back. So the system was insane. Probably shaking everything, right? And then we come around again. He puts the Too Short song, you know, on Tupac's part where he's rapping. And, you know, again, he like waves at us or whatever. And now, like, that I think about it, because in that scene, he's with Tim Roth. So Tim Roth was probably with him, and we didn't even see him, or we didn't pay attention, right? We were like more Tupac fans. You know, I don't know if Pulp Fiction had came out yet or what. But, you know, he must have been right there with Tupac, and we just didn't even notice him. So, you know, we passed by again the second time, bumping that Tupac and Too Short song. And I forgot who else was on it. And then, you know, Frank Alexander, which was Tupac's bodyguard, he yells at us, hey, why y'all keep passing through here? He gets kind of close, you know, because we're going slow. So Tupac could hear. And so, you know, when he waved at us and everything, and he gets kind of close. And my friend, you know, Mr. Cool Guy, because, you know, he was driving, he yells at him. He goes, fuck you. So we just go, or F you. I'll edit it to say F you, you know, whatever. He says that. I'll just leave it in. It is what it is. I'll leave the, you know, one bad word in the whole video. So anyways, he yells at him. And then, so after that, we don't come back no more, right? Because he killed it because of that. But it was cool. We were all happy. You know, we saw Tupac. You know, who knew he was going to get killed? You know, so I'm guessing that had to be between April and June, right? Because I was still in school. You know, we had ditched. Tupac didn't start filming Gridlock till, I believe, they said he had got out of jail, and it took 6 months, which would have been April of 96. He got killed in September, so, and it was, you know, while I was still in school. So it had to be between April and June of 96 that we saw him here. And like I said, they said the movie was in Detroit, but, you know, it actually is right here. And then I'll screenshot it, put all that stuff. And yeah, man, and then Frank Alexander was, you know, they found him with a, you know, bullet wound to the head. They said it's suicide, but, you know, there was so much stuff surrounding that who knows, right? It was in 20, because I had seen interviews of him, and he seemed like he was a pretty well put together guy, right? He was doing good. You know, they had interviewed him and everything. And then in 2013, April 28, I believe, of 2013, they find him, you know, with a, you know, that it was a apparent suicide or something, or that's what they said. So anyways, yeah, that's what they were both there. It was crazy. You know, so that's the only encounter I had with Tupac. You know, he was my biggest inspiration making music. You know, he wasn't the reason I started making music, but he was my biggest inspiration as I started making music. So, you know, it was an honor to see him. And who knew that later on, like, you know, I'd be working on movie sets all around here. Maybe we filmed there before too, you know. So you know, for a kid seeing his, who was my idol at the time or whatever, or my biggest inspiration, and then, you know, to kind of try to follow in those footsteps, right? So yeah, that's my Tupac story. Hope you guys enjoyed it. You know, I'll put the screenshots of all that. Oh yeah, back then nobody had cell phones with cameras on there, so we couldn't just snap a shot of Tupac. If not, I'm sure everyone, he would have had a crowd taking selfies and all that. And, you know, Okay, so I didn't want to make this too long, but just real quick, another funny story, right? So in that scene, before they're walking through those that whole street and everything, there's a scene where Tupac and Tim Roth are putting rocks into a camera case, like to sell as a camcorder, right? Like they would sell a box with a camcorder, but for the weight, they would put a rock inside, right? And then they'll sell it to you. And so it was funny. I don't think it was on that trip, but it might have been a few weeks before, a few weeks after. That happened to a friend of mine. We came, like I told you, we would always come to get stuff here because, you know, there was a lot of stuff they didn't have over there that they had here in downtown LA. And so this guy sells, my friend, he comes, hey, you want to buy a camcorder? You know, I think he tells him $200, and then he's like, nah, it's something. He keeps bringing it down, 160, one this. Or maybe it started with like 500, because in the movie, it's funny. He's like, how am I going to sell you a, I don't know, it's like over $1,000 camera for, you know, and then the guy keeps hustling him. I'll give you 100 for it, you know, eventually. So that's what happened with my friend. And then that guy never looked back. Once he gave him like, I don't know how much, he probably gave him like $60 at the end, but it was for, you know, just a big old rock. Like we get in the van, I believe, and we open it up because my friend was driving, and he's, oh, well, what? He's there's, I don't know if he said it's broken or there's no remote or something, and we started just busting up, and you know it was a rock, right? That guy. So they did that in that movie, and I was like, that's so funny, because that's real. You know what I mean? That's what like the homeless people around here. I don't even know if they were homeless, but they would do that, right? They'll sell you a camcorder, make it seem like, oh, like we're getting over on them, but really they were getting over on us, right? And so, you know, that was the most expensive rock, I guess, that I seen someone buy. I don't know how much he paid, really. I don't remember. But in the movie, you know, they sell it to that guy that then he starts chasing him, trying to kill him over the $80 that he paid for a rock, right? Or a brick or whatever. So, I don't know. I just thought that was funny. All right. So, that's enough for that story. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I got so many stories. Let's see if anything else could come up that I'll make a video about. But yeah, that was my one and only, you know, encounter with Tupac. And yeah, I feel lucky that I was able to, you know. All right, peace. You